to me, the weirdest thing that's going on, but I am 52. And yes, I know my lighting is not good. It makes my hair look all dry or greasy or whatever, but as you can see, up and down today. For a couple of days, my head's been aching. It's all right. But this minimalist living and stuff, some of the suggestions are really weird to me because it's the way that I always live my life, and I never thought anything of it. I don't buy knickknacks. The only stuff that's in my house is my artwork or pictures, photographs of my children. Yeah, or drying herbs. I have a cottage style, you know. Or, you know, pottery that my son made in high school. And I reuse bread bags, and I reuse Ziploc bags, and I always have. If there was something dry in them, there's no reason to not reuse them. And I never was one for subscriptions. The only subscription that I have is Amazon Prime, and that's because I can get it for like $5 a month because I'm just on disability. And I don't wear makeup, and I haven't for the longest time. And I use less shampoo since I shaved my head into a death box. But a lot of things I don't understand. I did clean out my closet, though, stuff that I had just sitting there, because since I'm housebound and then the pandemic, I never used to go out much anyways. But why keep stuff thinking, well, I might go out? It's like I have my motorcycle gear that I hang on to, you know, my leathers. But other than that, it's like, I'm not going anywhere. So why do I need more than one dress when I don't wear dresses? I wear skirts, sweats, and then some different jeans, not. That's it, and t-shirts, and flannel shirts, and then I have this thermal shirt today. And I have a skirt on. It's not really fashionable, but who am I seeing? No one. And I don't understand this straw phenomenon, where you guys are spending money on straw and water bottles. Makes no sense to me. Here's my cup. You know, and this is the cup that they give you when you have a baby. Let's see, which hospital is this? I can't even see what hospital it is anymore. Just a second. Drinking water. I don't need a straw. I don't need a cup that's covered. And how do you clean inside those straws? Why do you need reusable straws? Why do you need straws? I don't understand. And why do you need razors, some of these bizarre things? I mean, because there's always been razors that were, you keep the razor part and you just get the blade. That's always been something that you could do. And you can get one lotion to use on your whole body, and that's what I do. I don't know. My toothbrush, I just have a toothbrush and I change it out when I need to change it out. It's not enough plastic to be that concerned about, in my opinion. I have a truck, but I don't drive, and if I drive, because of my health problems as part of it, and if I do drive, it's just really close around here. If I could, I would ride a bike with a basket, but my balance isn't good enough to ride a bike. but I'm not really contributing to emissions and stuff when my truck is parked. 98% of the time. I'm trying to think of what else you guys have spent money on. The plug-in air freshener things and bath and bodywork stuff. I use essential oils. And there's just only a couple of those that don't bother me. And you can also reuse the wax from, if you use wax melts, you can reuse the wax and you can put some essential oil in there. You can put it in a mason jar. And then in the winter time, you can put a pan of water on your stove, put that in the middle, and then you have scent and moisture in the air during the winter. Kill two birds with one stone. I do lots of things that I just never really thought of. There's a whole bunch more, but I can't think of them because they're just normal to me. I don't know. I don't go and buy plants, and I have gardens and stuff. I do spend money on seeds, but the only plants that I buy are, like, I need to get some raspberry bushes because we're not getting enough raspberries for the demand here. But you make friends with your neighbors. It's hard to do anymore, but you trade plants. There's no reason to go spend money on plants when you can get starts of plants and seeds off of neighbors' plants in your neighborhood. I don't know why people aren't doing that. I don't know if you guys just haven't thought about it in your generation or what. I don't know. And then simplifying your life, I plug my phone in downstairs instead of in my room, so my phone's not in my room when I'm in bed, unless it's daytime. And then at, like, come 7 o'clock, I plug it in down here. Sometimes I don't take it up at all to my room. Picture frames that I already have. I have layers of things in the picture frames. Like, I changed out some pictures today to put my paintings in there. For I had artwork from when I was 18, 19 hanging up, and I'm like, okay, I want to change that. I'm 52. So I go to change it, and inside there's pictures of me, there's old pictures, you know, because it's the best way to store your pictures, your photographs, or your artwork, is to leave them in the frame if you have enough room behind the new picture that you put in. Just remember if you go to get rid of it, or if, you know, someone wants to buy the paint, the piece of art. I do that, and then that takes up less storage room too. I've always reused t-shirts for rags and for my art, and sometimes the rag that I've been using, I will put it on as a shirt. Have paint all over it and stuff. I don't know. Things just, people make things too difficult. Life is just really that simple. I don't understand why people need dishwashers. And then with dishwashers, then they need the special detergent to go in there and the spot stuff. And that just seems unnecessary to me. I don't understand garbage disposals. But yes, I have both. I don't use the dishwasher. It doesn't work. I mean, to me, just wash the dishes. You're going to wash them anyways before you put them in the dishwasher. Microwave. Yes, I have a microwave, but yeah, when it dies, I don't plan on getting another one. And I would be fine without a microwave. I have a coffee maker, but I also have a percolator, which, if the coffee maker breaks, I just use the percolator. The one that you use out camping, you know? I don't understand the big deal. Just lots of little things, I don't know. You can ask me questions. baskets that I have hanging up on my wall, I will take them down and use them if I need a basket. Mason jars, when I dry my herbs, I put them in my mason jars that I keep and reuse. Mason jars are cups. We use the mason jars as cups. If I use a plate during the day and it's just for like toast or something, I leave the plate on the counter and I use it all day instead of getting a new plate out. I also don't just sit down and eat regular meals. What I'll eat is, and this is healthy too. When I was bodybuilding, you eat 6 meals a day. They don't have to be meals, and it's, anyway. I'll eat nuts and whatever cheese I have. I like feta the best. And fruit. And let's see, it'll be walnut. Right now it's walnut and pumpkin seeds and feta cheese and dried apples. Apples that I buy in a bag. The Granny Smith I'll buy in the, you know, the biggest bag at the store. And I dry them. I have an apple tree, but I don't know what kind of apples it is. I think it started out as one kind of apple, and then it's just grown to be huge. And the tree's beautiful. I'm not taking it down. But the apples, they're only good for eating and when they're not ripe, when they're small. So they're not good. You can't juice them. And I don't like how they taste dried, which is a bummer. But I do freeze my grapes. You can take grapes off of the grapevine and just put the whole thing in a freezer bag and then freeze them. And you can reuse those freezer bags too if you take the grapes out to thaw them out instead of leaving them in the freezer bag to thaw them out. I also, when I grow pumpkins and we use them for Halloween, I bake the pumpkins and I puree them and I put it in the fridge. I mean in the freezer. And so all winter I don't make pumpkin pie just at one time of the year. I make it whenever I want. And recipes, I adapt stuff to them. I no longer use sugar. I haven't used sugar in recipes for a long time, but I use agave nectar. I'll use honey. You know, whatever works. I keep running across lemon poppy seed recipes with yogurt in. Why the hell would you put yogurt in them? I don't, just take the yogurt out. The recipe will work fine without the yogurt. Trust me. And just use the agave instead of sugar. Yeah. I'll just do things like that. And then I have a big bucket of flour. I need to get less flour because it's just me now. I'm an empty nester, so I'm learning how to buy, not in bulk anymore, buying just for me. And not to have, I was born in Utah, so I was born doing the food storage. And I don't need that much food storage when it's just me. Because a lot of it, when you're rotating it, you got to throw it out, and that's not good. So I'm restraining my brain to not do that. But I have a 72-hour kit. I don't understand why people were, whenever they're worried about something like with the pandemic, they buy toilet paper and water. I don't understand that. Do you guys not have containers that you can put water in? Do you not have water purifiers? Do you not have iodine? What are you thinking is going to happen? And why are you wasting your money on water at the store in plastic bottles? I don't understand. And toilet paper. Toilet paper is not a necessity. All you have to do is get a spray bottle, and it's the same as a bidet. You can get those science ones that have the long things, you know, the ones that hold whatever chemicals in the lab, and then they have the long straw thing. And that does just as good as a bidet. Why are you guys freaking out? I don't understand at all. buying loads of that stuff. I'm like, why toilet paper? Why water? I really didn't understand. I had to have someone explain it to me. Because I was raised, you know, I know how to survive. You guys need to learn these things. I swear. And then the Texas thing, some of that I didn't understand the freaking out over, but, you know, it would suck to have no electricity and have my water pipes broke. But what I would have done to begin with, when there was concern about water pipes breaking, is I would have went out, I would have filled up water bottles, you know, whatever big containers I had with water. And then I would have went out to the street and turned off the water at the street, so there's no water going through your sprinkling system, there's no water going to your house, and then you run your faucets until no more water comes out. Then what you have done is empty your lines as much as possible. That's what I would have done for that. But that, I'm just saying, that's no, neither here nor there at this point, I guess, but. Yeah, and I have 50 billion blankets that I keep. Because the power goes out here in Utah. And then, luckily, we have a fireplace. And I think a fireplace is a good thing to have. Because, you know, we can't use it a lot of times because there's no burn because of the air. But when the power goes out, yeah, you're glad that you have the fireplace. And then I have candles, and then I have those lights where you can recharge them. But the rechargeable lights aren't going to last very long, you know, if you got to plug them into the computer stuff and recharge them, unless you go someplace where you can recharge your phone and do the light at the same time during the day. But my first thing was, why didn't people just go camping? My brain just thinks that way. But, yeah, that's what I would have done with the water and stuff. But I've been camping in all sorts of weather. So, not a big thing. I have a fire pit that's above ground. But you can always dig one. What are they going to say? No. When there's something going on like this, because you can always fill it in. Just make sure you're not hidden by any pipes or whatever. You know? And then, like, just make it like you're camping out once you turn off your water. It's the same thing, but you just buy a house. I don't know. That's just my thoughts. I guess I'm just old because that's automatically what my brain does. I don't understand. My son will tell me something, or I'll see something on the news. I'm like, why? Why? Yeah. I've cut my own hair the whole time during the pandemic. And I even shaved it myself for the death talk. But, I mean, it's not perfect, but I'm not a perfect person. I don't need perfect hair. And the haircut, actually, it wasn't hard. I wouldn't do a really short haircut if you're pulled up. I'm lying. I'd probably cut my hair no matter what length it was. Because I'm just like that. I need to cut like 10 inches off again. I'm not kidding, 10 inches. I cut that off during the pandemic earlier. My hair grows like a weed. And then I make some of my own teas with the herbs out of my yard. And then I have some to share. But usually the only people who want any are people in my family that were raised the same way as me. You can use stuff as tea, you can use stuff as medicine. Just, you can use a lot of stuff for lots of things. It's amazing when you just open your mind. Yeah. Okay, well, I can't think of anything else. So if you have questions, let me, you know, ask them, and then I'll answer them, because you probably have more stuff that you could ask that I can't think of because it's just my normal life. All right, guys. Hugs and love. Try to think positive and remember just the important stuff and roll with the punches. You have to adapt and overcome. I've learned that, especially with chronic illness, because it's always changing. There's nothing you can do about it. You can get angry, you can get upset, or you can just accept and adapt your life. That's what I didn't understand about the pandemic stuff with some things, is it's reality. You have to adapt and overcome. Whining about it doesn't help, and fighting doesn't help. All right, now I'm really done. Hugs and love. Bye.